From a young age, something that was always ingrained in my mind was that men should be the breadwinners for a family. Through my father's own behavior, I realized that because some men support their households economically, they automatically have the power to make all decisions for the entire household. In our house, it was my father that made decisions. So, it was natural for me to believe that the male figures play the role of a decision maker as well. Since now I work and earn a living of my own, I thought I should be the one to make the decisions at home. As my wife didn't have the ability to do on her own, neither do my children. For an example, when my wife prepares food every day, she always asks me what I would like to eat. I make the decisions on what everyone else eats as well. When there is something concerning my son or my daughter's education, my wife asks me about what should be done. This led me to think that I not only make the financial decisions in the family, but I make the final decisions on everything. Decisions like how many children are we going to have, or when we should engage in sexual intercourse, are all decided by me. After a few years, after the children were born, I thought that their day-to-day activities took place according to my likes and dislikes. I didn't give them the space to make their own decisions. But this did not continue for long. One day, my daughter asked me if it was right that I should make all the decisions at home just because I was the man of the house or because I earned the money. Wasn't it necessary for me to respect the opinions of all my family members in order to build a beautiful family life? This made me stop and think about my own day-to-day behavior. I realized that I had controlled everything in the house. Everyone had worked according to my plans and the way I wanted them to do. It was only the food that I liked, prepared in the way I liked, that was cooked in the household. We went on trips to places that I chose. I understood that the happiness of my family members was hindered and shouldn't be controlled by me. We took steps to listen to everyone's ideas and make collective decisions. From that day on, I saw the happiness in my wife and kids through their smiles and laughter. Everyone was interested and helped out with the housework. However, it wasn't easy for me to make the changes immediately. This is because in our society, all my friends were still making the decisions for their own households. I believe that they still haven't realized their own loss in that. But I will take the initiative to have a discussion with my own friends, bearing the happiness of their families in mind. I want to be an example in our society and a family member that respects the opinion of others. From my own experience, I know that such understanding and respect in the family leads to happiness and peace for all.